What's up, guys? It's your boy Tyon Posey, back with the Rappers War podcast solo edition. Just me, you know, my boy Chizzy be back. This is our second episode, emergency pod. We had to get in the lab and talk about this shit. I'm gonna do a quick breakdown of this shit before we get into these records and dissecting what the fuck is going on. So, Drake and Kendrick Lamar. These two have been beefing for the better part of my damn adulthood, shit, adolescence. We can take it all the way back to the Control verse when Kendrick Lamar was still up and coming but was hungry and was one of the newest guys. I would say Drake wasn't the top guy. There was still Kanye and Jay-Z and a couple other guys that was fighting with Drake. But Drake was right there as the new guy, the rookie of the year, as you will. He was a generational prospect to go along with the great artists that we had at the time. He was on hit singles, DJ Khaled singles. He was with Lil Wayne, who was also the hottest artist at the time. And he was supplanting him alongside a roster with Young Money that was killing the nation. I know this because I was a kid that thought I was in Young Money. You know what I'm saying? Kendrick Lamar was different. He was backpack. He was underground. We knew he was a great rapper. We didn't know they can make great songs. Then he started making great songs. He made great projects from Section 80 to Good Kid, Mad City. Even Overly Dedicated, which was a great album to start off. We go to Take Care, which Tom would say is Drake's big classic, the big joker in his catalog. Got Kendrick Lamar with his own interlude feature track, Buried Alive, where he's talking about how Drake is where he wants to be. And he's like, damn, this nigga the same age as me. Because they only like 1 year apart. He's like, damn, this nigga damn near my age. You doing all this shit. I got to step my game up. People don't talk about that. But Drake was kind of like Kendrick's OG. Or like the class right after him. You know, when you went through the rookie year, you know how everything about to go. So you can give game to the dude that potentially might take your spot. Which is a great way to wrap this all the way around to where we stand today. Let's click through some points. Control verse comes out. Everybody's like, whoa, niggas touch Drake because he's the nigga that's his peer. Niggas don't be like, oh, Jay-Z say something, Kanye say something, Eminem say something. Out of all the niggas he named, Drake was the top one out of the peer group. Obviously, there were guys like Cole and Big Crit and Wale, Meek Mill, Big Sean, who was on the record as well. But then Drake kind of didn't love it. He was like, damn, you kind of getting some juice off my name, off everybody's name, but off my name. And I fuck with you, Kendrick, but I don't think you're on my level. Kendrick obviously doesn't think he's on the bottom of anybody's level. So it's a great battle of wit. It's a great battle of ego, honestly. That battle is about ego and who thinks they're the best. From Control, we go to the interviews that Drake had. With plenty of outlets being like downplaying the Control verse, which led to the BET cipher. High five. Joke's on you. I'm bulletproof. Like that whole BET cipher, which was amazing. And then that led to On Record. We got Drake calling him out, saying, I brought my tour to your city. You my son there. On the 100 remix, shooting that in Games Hood. Then Kendrick and Drake going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. But all of that shit is hearsay. All that shit is shit that we thought happened or we knew happened, but then it kind of passed. We didn't know where they were standing as far as the relationship goes. Well, now we fucking know. First person shooter comes out. Nobody thinks it's a diss. Nobody thinks it's a slight to anybody. We found out that Drake and J. Cole tried to get Kendrick on that song, which would have been a great moment, by the way. Tried to get the three big goats, the big three on the same song together. Kendrick either said no or it got misconstrued. The song comes out. Kendrick takes it like, oh, these niggas clicking up like against me. And you know he's not taking that shit lightly. He go team up with some niggas that's trying to take out Drake. Because Drake is the big joker here. Cole is just like playful, like lyricism shit. Drake is the nigga they want to take out. For maybe good reason. We'll talk about that within the Kendrick disses. That comes out. The Like That verse comes out. He's going to shoot at Drake, but a little bit of Cole. Cole jumps out the window with 7 Minute Freestyle niggas are like, this is pretty hard, but also it ain't no knockout. It's a good starter to the feud, but niggas don't really fuck with it. Cole, it don't sit right with my spirit, man. It don't sit right with my spirit. Whatever the fuck that nigga said, which was some bitch shit, if I might add. But looking back on it, he might have had a point because this shit getting treacherous. We go from that moment to Drake teasing the red button, Kendrick being really quiet, and Drake is like, I've got something for that, like that. That went number one is going crazy. Bet I'm gonna drop push-ups. Well, pause. He didn't really drop it. It got leaked and then it got put out. They thought it might have been AI. Was it AI? Who fucking knows? But push-ups comes out. I'm like, okay, the boy fighting back. Push-ups is a nice jab, a nice warning shot. Little did we know, in 17 days it would get Euphoria, which is a great diss track. It's hitting Drake in many different areas without revealing it really anything. It's like, nigga, you a little weird with girls. Nigga, you ain't that good of a father. You a terrible father even. You kind of a fucked up person. You fake as fuck. Nigga, you black, but nigga, is he really black? I don't even think you should really say nigga, because like, what do you get from that? You from Canada, nigga? Like, you ain't really part of this culture. You just gain from this culture. A great attack. And there's so many shit in that verse, niggas are still finding shit from that verse to put into this beat. And it's like, oh, Drake, you're on the clock, buddy. You're on the clock, buddy. You better motherfucking represent, as I rock the LeBron jersey to show you that. I'm just repping all GOATs today, because this is a GOAT day in hip-hop. And then Kendrick doubles down with 616 in Compton. Yeah. I think or LA. 616 in LA. One of the two. And he's going back and forth with this nigga. Like, I'm on your fucking head. And you got informants in your camp. And I know you do. And yeah, nigga, you should have stopped. You shouldn't have said my wife's name in that push-up shit when you was dissing everybody. Mind you, the Future albums too dropped. Two classics, by the way. Well, one classic and Impossible. Two great albums from Future and Metro that basically started this shit. The niggas got to be like, when you in the fucking like classroom with all of your friends and it's like, you roasting. And you like, man, your shoes weak as shit, right? And then you go back and forth, like, oh, man, your shoes weak as shit. And if somebody like, man, I heard this nigga hate all your fits. You like, wait, nigga. You hate all my fits? And then now y'all go back, nigga, you ain't never wore nothing good a day in your life, nigga. And then the other nigga be like, well, nigga, the shit you wore yesterday, that shit was that nigga's clothes. And you ain't even wash your ass the other day. Like, damn, nigga, like, damn, how the fuck you know if I ain't wash my ass? The fucking, who told you that? Little do you know, your fucking little sister told him that because you've been staking the fucking house. So your mama didn't fucking told everybody, this nigga ain't wash his ass. Now she didn't fucking told the school. Now you missed the ain't wash your ass. Like, that's what's happening in this battle. In a different schedule. Like, you know, let me rein it in. But that's what's happening in this battle. Like, every single moment. The reason Drake beat Meek and it was so decisive was because Drake fucking controlled the narrative. Meek said he ain't even writing his shit. Which is a crazy motherfucking thing to put on somebody's ledger, especially writing in rap music. And Drake said, bet, I got something for that. We do a charge dump. Like, let me let you know I'm writing and I'm thinking about you. But I know you're on tour, so you may not even respond. And it ain't even that hard of a song. I think it's hard. It's not a hard song where it's like, damn, like something happens. So everybody's like, we fuck with it, Drake, but you know, it's cool, it ain't amazing. Couple days. Back to back. Bitch, where the fuck is you at? I told you we fighting at fucking 5 o'clock when the school doors let open. That's a little late, but you know, Cleveland Public School, they fucked this up with the 4 o'clock let-ups. But at 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 2 o'clock, whenever school is over, I'm outside, nigga. I'm out fucking side. And that's what Kendrick is doing to him right now, man. With the Euphoria drop, taking his time to drop it, getting the information, all that, as we will come to see. Then the 616 drop, the same way Drake dropped TaylorMade, which I forgot to mention, Drake did the AI stunt where he brought on the elders to talk to Kendrick. He was bullying Kendrick. Kendrick bullied him with the like that, like, fuck y'all niggas, y'all clicking up. Drake tried to pull a Meek, like, I'm on your head, nigga. And then Kendrick was like, nigga, you know you not. And then came back like Euphoria. Fuck both of them distance. Fuck it. 616. It's a mid, a little key, but it's good enough. But now, fuck you, nigga. Another one. And we like, okay. Kendrick shot his load. Maybe he's gonna regroup now, see what Drake has to offer. And that's what he did. But in a weird way. So what we didn't know is the cover art for 616 is a glove. A Maybach driver glove. We will come to find out on Meet the Grams, which was the diss track that came out literally 25, 30 minutes after Drake dropped his latest diss track, Family Matters. Like, literally, we are digesting the Drake diss track in the group chat, on Twitter. You're seeing people going crazy. It was like Drake going crazy, or people that haters on Twitter. I'm going to get into them in a second. But the haters on Twitter are like, oh, this ain't the nuke. This ain't the red button that Drake been talking about. This ain't enough. Even though that shit is hard as hell. But, you know, niggas be hating on this bitch for no reason. Social media is the craziest place because you can just hate free willingly, not show your face, not show who you is, not have no real opinions, not really ever be involved in music, try to make a song, do a jingle, no shit about nothing, but you can fucking have an opinion. Or you can used to be a fan of another person, and then now that this person don't rate you no more or fuck with you, now you all on this other person's Johnson, you know what I'm saying? Because he going against this person. Like, what we've learned from this battle, if everything is true, that both of these niggas are terrible people. But the thing about this battle is, if they are terrible people, somebody got to be the least terrible. So whoever you think is the least terrible, or whoever you side with in the beef, is who you're going to side with. See, me, I'm impartial. I'm a bigger Drake fan than a Kendrick fan, yes, but both of these niggas basically raised me musically. So I'm in it to see both of these niggas shine. Right now, I think they're both shining. Do I think they're both getting the same credit or fairness in the battle? No. Niggas want Drake to fall, but the thing is that Drake has been so prevalent and omnipresent in society as a hip-hop artist that, yes, we want to see this nigga fall, because he hasn't. Nigga, Pusha T revealed that he had a child that we didn't know about. And I don't know, like, oh, I'm protecting my child like on some Halle Bailey, Beyonce shit. No, like, you had a child and was not, like, purposely not putting this nigga out there. He wasn't no infant either. This nigga had hair already and everything. Albino baby Jesus came fucking like, what the, who the fuck is this nigga? Like type shit. But, like, it happened. And Drake still withstood that. So niggas are, like, kind of seeing the dents in the armor. People have already said the albums haven't been as good as they used to be. The rap ain't been as good as it used to be. Whether that was a Joe Budden narrative or not. We're seeing that come to fruition. And now it's time to test it. And if another nigga that we love and also doesn't come outside, like Drake said in Push Ups, like a hot verse every 30 months or some shit like that. Like, it's like we waiting for this nigga to speak because he don't speak. And now he's speaking about this one nigga that we already hate or already are tired of seeing win to the point where we trash his last album, even though it was pretty fucking good. And the one before that too, and the one before that too. Like, it's fucking, it's a, like, Kendrick should win this battle. But the fact that Drake has taken it so seriously and has been so good in the battle, I think he's dropped three great diss songs to go along with Kendrick's three great diss songs is amazing. If you got it 3-0 Kendrick, 3-0 Drake, 2-1, 1-2, whatever you got it, I respect you. If you respect both sides. But I'm the most impartial nigga on YouTube. COE Media is the fucking best YouTube channel to go to for this. And Rapper's War is the best podcast about this shit because we get straight into it. And we call them out, you fucking frauds. Let's pause the beef. It's a beef cast. I'm going to get to you fucking frauds. Let's talk about the women frauds first. The Elises or the... I forget the lady. I've been in her spaces a couple times. I got put down today because I was yelling. And I was just trying to get these niggas to understand that you don't have to be biased in this shit. We don't know these people. Nobody knows Drake. Nobody knows Kendrick. We don't know if this nigga Drake is hiding a child or Kendrick is beating his wife or Drake is a fucking nigga that carry around with pedos or Izzy is a pedo or, like, we don't know these niggas. Hopefully none of this shit is true so we can enjoy these niggas as performers. But you don't know these people. So to be so biased, with, especially if you consider yourself a journalist that was out buying OVO merch, but then as soon as the nigga don't fuck with you or say your opinion is weird, now it's, oh, fuck this nigga, and oh, he's a... Like, these people don't give a fuck about the accusations. if these accusations are true, then we should be getting rid of these niggas. But niggas don't care about that shit. This shit is so stan cultured, like the fucking owl accounts that got an owl and OVO and a fucking pumpkin for October in their shit. I'm born in October, so shout out. But I'm just saying, like, in their shit, can't give Kendrick any props. And then the niggas that have, I don't know, a fucking pen, a piece of paper, the boogeyman emoji, whatever the fuck that shit is, for Kendrick, can't fucking see that Drake is doing some incredible shit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show both sides of these two new disses. And we're going to react to the words, some of the visuals, and really give y'all niggas, like, the quickest deep dive. We're going to be back. I'm bringing some of my friends. Rappers World be back with more people just to give y'all niggas, like, because this shit is crazy. This shit is crazy. Like, it's the morning time over here in Houston, and I am fucking geek. Like, the fucking, back to the rap battle. The fucking, oh, I didn't touch them in. Y'all niggas are weirdos, but y'all goofies. Y'all can't beat me up, so it don't fucking matter anyway. But the battle that was going forth is so fun. Like, we're like, Drake drop. Oh, shit, the game is in disarray. You know what I'm saying? On the Drake lyric shit. And then Kendrick pops up. The niggas talking about there's, like the views battles is going on. Like, this is one of the craziest nights in hip-hop, like, ever. Like, fucking, niggas don't understand how much I fucking love this rap shit. I love the rap so much that when this rap shit sucks, which it has sucked for a very long time, this shit makes me not want to even listen to music. Like, you can compare my Apple fucking music listening history from January to now. It doesn't even fucking register because I've been listening to music so much more since the Future tape. Shout out Metro. Shout out Future because y'all niggas really started this shit. Like, this hatred shit has fueled some great records. We've been asking for Drake just to fucking rap for how long? He did on Scary Hours as the precursor to this shit, damn near. Her Loss too with precursors and some shit. Like, it's so much shit. And also, the thing that's crazy about this shit is, this shit is going to make everybody's catalog in these beats or surrounding these beats for the past couple years so much better. Like, niggas are going to look at fucking Her Loss and For All the Dogs way better than when that shit first dropped. Niggas are going to look at the Offseason by J. Cole or Mr. Morale and Big Steppers in a different light. I got niggas saying Mr. Morale and Big Steppers is a classic. A fucking classic because Kendrick is going so crazy right now. So revisionist history, niggas are like, oh no, look at this. He was breaking this shit down. Now he's breaking Drake down. And now, oh my God, look at Therapy album, the best album ever. That shit better than this. I fucked Mr. Morale off the fucking get-go because I understood it. And I fucking really fucking love somebody being so true to themselves that they can let you know I'm a fucked up individual at times. And this is what changed, why I needed to change because I went through some fuck shit. I love that look in the mirror. But nigga, that shit ain't no classic V. The fuck? That shit's good raps. Good raps, good schemes, good beats even in some pockets. But that shit is kind of all over the place for a Kendrick album. There's some forgettable tracks. There's some forgettable schemes. His big hit off of it in 95 doesn't last. Nobody's playing 95 right now. It isn't even the best version of that type of style from Kendrick. There's great songs on that bitch. Father Time is probably one of my favorite Kendrick songs ever, and that's on that bitch. But I'm just saying, like, it isn't an all-time Kendrick project. The revisionist history about this battle will change that. Niggas will look at Her Loss as the shit that started this shit. Like, that started this whole Future beef and all this shit. Niggas will look at these Future albums with, like, these bitches ignited the fucking feeling back in hip-hop. The last time we had mainstream disses like this was ASAP. I'm tripping ASAP, dude. Fresh on my mind from the new disses. But was Drake and fucking Pusha. And that shit ended with getting a great first half of Scorpion, which I think is the best half on Scorpion, when he rewrote everything and went in. We got fucking Daytona, which is a fucking classic for short, as far as short albums goes. We like, it uplifted Pusha. Drake took a little bit of a fucking popularity hit, but as far as his name, he was still out there. Like, this diss and shit has elevates every fucking era. Tupac and Biggie's, like, RIP. Because there was lives lost in that, so it's different. But it elevated the era. When you think about that era, even before you think about their death, you think about their impact. And that diss hit them up still lives today. Who shot you still gets ringed today. No Vaseline gets ringed today. That's damn near the epicenter. Fucking, like, we could talk about old school rap battles. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just crazy. We can talk about Eminem going at fucking Ja Rule, and it was tag team and Ja Rule. We can talk about, like, this Drake and Kendrick shit will live on forever. We got to witness this shit in real time tonight. So be proud of yourself, Twitter, or niggas that got insomnia that can't go to sleep and shit, or got shit to do, college student and shit like me. But we got to see some real shit. So let's get into these disses. We got Drake, Family Matters. Let's hear what we got going on.
Maybe in this song? You shouldn't start by saying, nigga, I said it, I know that you mad. I've emptied the clip over Friendly or Jazz. You mentioned my scene, I deal with his dad. I gotta go bad.
Okay, pause. Start that right there. You mentioned his seed, now you gotta deal with the dad. Obviously, he's talking about Adonis, and it's talking about everything that was said in Euphoria as far as, like, I think I hate this about you, and you a bad dad, you don't know nothing about dad, like that whole scheme. So let's see where he takes it. This is the fucking song that was on the fucking backhand of Push Ups. So you know he's had these verses for a while. Maybe small updates here and there, but keeping the PG lane. Basically trying to say that this nigga is, he ain't who he say he is. Shout out Chris Breezy, I guess. Pause. I think that's a good point. In these battles where niggas are throwing accusations, I think the funny thing about that line is that it goes for Drake and Kendrick. If you're going to say, you fucking better have some paperwork for that fake tea. So, like, nigga, you gonna say this about me? You saying I got a kid, which we'll get to. Or you saying I fucking hang with pedos, which we'll get to. Or you saying I got a gambling addiction? Well, I guess we can see the fucking, he posts that shit himself. But anything you say about me, please have some fucking receipts. Because if you don't, then that shit ain't valid. But the thing I can say to Drake is, nigga, you about to say a lot of shit in this bitch. And if you ain't got receipts, I feel the same way about you, Crody. But let's see. Crazy. It's crazy to admit, like, first eight bars. Yeah, nigga robbed me. It was cool. Like, he robbed me, but what did that even really mean? Let me go back. So this part. Not that. Always rapping like you about to get the slaves free. Just acting like an activist. Make believe. I like the conviction in his voice. But nigga, you just got the culture vulture allegations, and now you saying nigga acting like he trying to free the slaves. If there were slaves, we would want them free, Drizzy. I'm sorry. Like, I fuck with Drake heavy, nigga. I even fucking bought a fake owl chain, nigga, because representing OVO, Scorpio shit, all that. Think Drake is one of the best artists of all time. Nigga. That's not a great angle. I fuck with that. Playing with the Good Kid, Mad City shit. I'm going to put it up there, but he got the minivan. He crushing that shit. Going, taking it back to Money Trees and shit. I fuck with it. And that's in between. Okay, now he's addressing, like, you hate the girls I fuck, but, like, what do you really mean by that? You the black messiah wiping up a mixed queen. And hit vanilla cream to help out with your self-esteem. If you listen to Mr. Morale and the Big Step, which is now considered a fucking classic by certain niggas, you would know that motherfucker likes himself some white haberdashery. Likes himself some white almond, if you will. Hey, man. You got a point with that, nigga? Like, hey. Hey, boy. You fucking with them whites? That's a crazy thing to do for a nigga that's claiming that nigga ain't culture. Why you fucking uncultured? Why you hopping around with white people on stages? Doing pop features with niggas if you talk about the culture so much? But hey, I don't know. That, I think that's a good mirror moment, Crowdy. Stupid ass. Okay. Getting into the wife. Mm. Say cheese. Okay, so he's like, nigga, I didn't want to do this shit. And the good thing about this track, and I was thinking about doing a video. I love the idea of doing videos for diss tracks. Kendrick will be doing that, by the way, and he will be doing it in a big way. You know, his nigga making South Park movies and shit. He gonna make a very creative video, and it's gonna go up. But this video is so cool. We have the lyrics in the middle of it, so I can recite lyrics as I'm watching the video. So I know what this nigga's saying. He might even show you something that relates to it in the video, which he does a lot in this. I can't pause this shit. The Rod will be here for an hour and a half, but yeah. Save me. That's true. She is a very like introspective lady. And he said you did her dirty all your, you did her dirty all her life. You trying to make peace. He's kind of, oh, Mr. That nigga Drake was listening to Mr. Morale for the past month. Like, because that is kind of what he's saying on that album. Obviously, there's more to it, but he is saying that on the album. Crazy accusation. Saying that one of your kids is your manager or nigga you hang with. That's crazy. Man, fucking sent to me. What? Okay. Now shake that ass for free. That's hard. That's hard. That's smart. You can be mad at the like, oh, nigga, like sampling or like putting in my hit record on another song. That's already like that's a cheat code, but hey, it might work. More high jokes. You see, Drake has kind of tried to keep this friendly. Like, obviously, he's saying some other shit, but his high jokes are like very like good. Like, you always thought I overlooked you, nigga. I was staring straight. Like, I didn't like, nigga. You just small. Like, that's funny as hell. No matter what I say, I know you like to keep it short. So let me paraphrase. Knew it was smoke when Abel hit us with the serenade. Nigga said, almost started reaching for my waist. It's cool. It's like, started singing. I was like, man, let me end this nigga. It's cool. I like the first song. It's a good song. Not no crazy disses. The Day Free shit is hard, though. Let's not forget. He did say some crazy accusations. I'm not even saying that shit true. But if you're going to do that for Kendrick, you got to do it for Drake. That's a crazy accusation, if true, with a very catchy beat. This is when that shit start getting real, though. Niggas are catching bullets this whole fucking beat. But niggas ain't gonna catch it until you really break this shit down. And that's why you come to the right place. COE Media shit. For sure. Yeah. Still mad about that one hoe. We ain't even fuck. I just lip locked with her. Talking about Bella Hadid. He like, I didn't fuck, bro. Like, why are you so mad about her? Drake, you a slimy nigga. Why are all these niggas mad at you about hoes? Like, why? Like, you done lost so many friends because you can't keep your either dick out your pants or your mouth off of these bitches. Like, you have a sex addiction, which makes what Drake, what Kendrick says on his next track after this one, kind of fucking direct. This nigga has a problem, yo. I love Drake, but this nigga be wildin'. Why is every nigga you claim to be cool with or claim to have rekindled friendships with always fall out with you? You got this nigga weekend on the best diss track of all time. I've been saying this in the chat because it's true. Like, I'm gonna never sign my life away. Like, and this nigga say you got leaks in your fucking operation because of you doing all this crazy shit. And then Kendrick came with the proof that you got leaks in your operation. Drake, get the fuck up! Get up! What my nigga Mick say? Get up! Like, you got leaks in your operation? Nigga Weekend did what Kendrick did fucking a month and a half ago. We Still Don't Trust You is still the best music that has come from this shit, by the way. Don't let these niggas try to maneuver their way into that shit. Future and Metro and The Weeknd and who else is on that bitch? Travis, whatever. The collective that made that body of work, that shit is amazing, nigga. But back to this shit.
When it's war time, I ain't even really let my dick drop, nigga. What the fuck?
He did drop. Ozempic is crazy when you think about what's coming next. That's hard. That's hard. Snowbug. Big flex. It's just flex bars, but those are big flexes, nigga. My last deal, 400 M's. This next one, nigga? This next one? That's a low bar, Crody. Hey,
who's next on this?
Who?
Which one of my so-called niggas? Which one of my so-called niggas? Which one of my so-called?
That shit got some meaning behind it. This niggas he really love for real. Look here,
man, city fan, we'll probably let him make the door stop. Tears running down my cheek, laughing at your pussy down. It's a war crime. Your music give me.
Tears running down my cheek, laughing at you pussies dying. It's a war crime. That is real fucking bars, nigga. You don't know nothing about that. That nigga is talking that grimy shit. Like, you can't tell me he wasn't ready for the smoke.
Getting played in all the spots where boys got a little more crime. That's why all your friends looking to Atlanta.
They might cancel you for that.
Able running fucking bread, need to buy some more chains for some more guys.
This whole second beat, he just started getting at niggas. First beat was mostly Kendrick with a couple Weekend jabs. The middle was just them niggas with a couple Kendrick jabs. And the last one was Kendrick. You gas cause you hit your BM first. Like, nigga, you hit your fucking baby mama first. Nigga, who you think I was hitting? The fuck? Like, if you was hitting my BM, nigga, I was hitting your BM. We just doing the same shit back to back. That's why I didn't think that ASAP Rocky just made any fucking sense. Like, oh yeah, I might have hit your bitch. I don't know if they hit your bitch. Nigga, he hit your bitch. Yeah, you made a family with the bitch, but he hit first. Was doing videos and shit. Ooh, nah. Like, what the fuck? Like, take care, all type of shit. She was trucking on this nigga 5 years after they broke up. Nigga, like, that's not that flex. Not a flex, Crowdy. Like, I mean, like, I don't know. ASAP got it bad. True. That's true as fuck. If you want to drop again and matter ASAP Rocky, tell Rihanna to get pregnant. And you can drop fucking, I don't know, the story of whatever you going to name Rihanna Jr. Because, like, ASAP Rocky niggas don't give a fuck about you. Like, you be dressing and shit, and that shit be fly. We give a fuck about that. But them raps, caca. Garage. We cool. In other words, shoot.
Pause.
Hey. The nigga Future. I know this is gonna be crazy. The nigga Future has not gotten dissed by this nigga Drake. He ain't caught a stray. Everything Drake even mentioned with Future is like, damn, like, this nigga Metro be on some whole shit. Like, you know me and you was cool, man. That mean either Drake know he fucked up with Future, or he really loved this nigga, bro.
Me and Wayne, you're fucking lame, so I know you had to be a
I don't learn much from these disses because I know these artists so well, but learning that Metro's real name is Leland Wayne, which I don't know because I don't look up that, like, he's a producer. Like, but his name being Leland Wade and just being finding that out in Drake diss track is fucking hilarious. I feel like Metro's gotten there the worst. Like, if you say that Drake's done the worst in this battle, Metro has done the worst. He's won because he got two great albums with Future. He also lost because, nigga, he be getting slaughtered and he can't say shit back. This is what's up, make some drums, nigga. You know what I'm saying?
They finally found a way to rope your head to it. Two separate albums, decent albums, did the key to it. Nigga, skim through it.
You probably should have listened to it. It was pretty good, dude. I do think Baby King writes some melodies for Kendrick. So, I don't think that's so. I think we all kind of think that, but also Kendrick writes for Baby King. Like, openly. He wrote it. He wrote like 8 of the songs on the Nigga album. So like, it's a weird diss, especially from a nigga like you who we know works on people with people on records. So weird diss, but we move. That's funny as hell. Y'all playing right. Hey, Drake, I know you're going, pause, because this last part is the most important part of the diss. Drake, I know that you're going on vacation. You were talking about this vacation for a minute, nigga. I know you want to go on vacation and you want to take a break. You want to damn near retire for 3. You want to pull a Kendrick and get the fuck away for a long time before you come back. But, nigga, you did not finish your food. I'm sorry. You know I fuck with you the long way, Kendrick. I said Kendrick. See? Nigga, fucking going into my fucking cerebral. This shit hard. The video to it is even hard. The imaging is hard. You got in the booth and you rapped 7 minutes. You hit every fucking target at least once. Multiple times for most. And it's good. The Jadakiss meme is good. But it's not enough. It's not enough. It's shit not over. If anything, Kendrick up. And if it's done now, most niggas will probably say Kendrick won. This beat, though, this is a fucking bop. I lucky wish this was the fucking song. What? Pause, nigga. Pause. Where is your uncle at, nigga? Where the fuck is your uncle, bro? I'm getting a little too stanny right now. But nigga, if you ever listen to Miss Miranda Big Step, which is a big contention to this argument or this conversation, and the Auntie Diaries and learning about the great real story he told about his auntie turning into his uncle and the religion and how that shit felt as a kid getting teased and how he wanted to be there for him and all this shit. Where your uncle at, nigga? Like, he the only real man between you and him, nigga. Like, so I want to know him. It's a crazy fucking bar. In a great way to tell this nigga, I fuck with you and I know you. But nigga, I know you. And I'm on your ass. That's hard. Then talk about LA niggas running faded while they talk about, oh, we can squabble up, you know what I'm saying? Fade to the fade. All right, nigga. We handing out whoopings, nigga. Come catch it, type shit. Come get this ass whooping. I'm in and I'm out. You want to take over for real? Do you? Crazy. I gotta put this shit in there. You wanna take up for Pharrell? Come get his legacy out of my fucking house? Got all the Neptune's chains and the shit. Bought him off the nigga like the nigga was going broke or something. And then fucking is full. Got the nigga Johnny Dang posted up with them hoes? Come you. Cause the nigga Kendrick said, for him I inherit the beef. That's what he said. I'm trying to say that. Man, here with the beef. Well, nigga. You, come on, and come get them. I got all them bitches on right the fuck now. And I'm in a spot with the Blammy, Crowdy. The place that nigga Kendrick somebody's in the spot with the Blammy, Drake just sitting in that bitch. Obviously rented it out. Crazy. You're like, no, nigga, I got some more season to this. Like obviously you know that like that's you got if you listen to Dan, obviously his dad got robbed or almost got robbed and that was the whole thing with that. So like you father son, we get that. That's not it's like a service it's a service level bar. Good bar, but you know, I'm just trying to get to the Kendrick shit too. Anthony set up the plays. Cold will be charging you double for none. They shook about what I'ma say. But texting and phone. Again, I like this fucking song. These beats are hard, these raps are hard, but there's a couple angles that I can poke flaws in. Like talking about this nigga's crew, because you know them obviously, and saying they scared I might drop a nuke. But they texting your phone saying we already won. If they're texting his phone saying we already won, they mean they think they won. They may be aware of your fucking skill set, because I think Ant was a big OVO guy. Aware of your skill set and understand like that you can come back. But if they texting the nigga thinking they already won, nigga, they think they won. Or they not think got something on you, that's unfucking winnable for you. Which the way Kendrick moving may be the case. You just may not know. Pause. No fucking Diddy. Or the way this next diss came from Kendrick. No fucking Drizzy. Nigga, what the frick are you doing? Like, I'm not even trying to cuss in this, but Jesus Christ, malarkey. This dude said, you said it's no big three. You was right. It's only Big D. Obviously referring to himself as Drake, but it's a double entendre for his video getting leaked. Which he probably leaked himself, which is what Kendrick referred to in the next one, which is why he brought it up. But, like, Nick, like, why? Like, we are in war. Why are you talking about your Johnson? We're in war. Strap up. And not in that way, Brody. Crody, whatever you call yourself, get a fucking grip. Jeez Louise, brother. That stinks. Brother, ew. Like, I'm a big Drake fan. Brother, ew. That is a wild bar. No Diddy, no Drizzy. Like, shit. No Kenny. None of that shit. Let's get to the next one. Shit's still hard, though, but jeez. Basically saying, let's go out play with our kids. They both light skin. Fuck it. Or you don't want to be seen with them for some reason. Bring it back to Dave Free shit. Do I believe the Dave Free shit? No. But obviously, we don't give a fuck about the niggas lying and it's this, or we would have been said something. So I'm down with the fucking lies. It's funny. It's entertaining. Let's keep it entertainment for now. What? When you put your hands on your girl, is it self-defense because she's bigger than you? Which is actively hilarious because Kendrick is 5'4", 5'5", 5'6", something like that. And this girl is definitely bigger than him. That shit nigga my hair. These niggas hate each other. If you think we get in a kumbaya moment, nigga, with these niggas sipping Bel Air or some shit together in 4 years, no. It may take 20. And even then, I don't think it'll happen. Why? Is it cause you live in a bachelor life? The pose in 2015. What? But don't wanna make her your actual wife. I'm guessing this wedding ain't happening right. Cause we know the girls that you actually like. The dog, the secrets are coming to life. It's all on your face like what happened to Mike. It's all making sense. Maybe I'm friends and you actually might. Michael's praying his features will change. So people believe that he's actually white. Top will make you features for change. Get on pop records and back for the white. So wait, you say your brother to me, but you only hear this day for the night. Oh shit. Just follow me right, cause nothing you say can bother me right. I get on the plane and nothing has changed. I handed it out of my ice. This part of the song is so crazy. This is the best shit I've heard. Maybe from both dishes. This is ridiculous. Alright, so this I'm about to break this shit down. You got that bar. Okay. It's approved. In that bachelor life, 15. Your actual wife. So this nigga thinks that Kendrick moved to New York to be away from his kids for some reason. And he said he proposed in 2015. So like they've been about to get married for a long time, but that's not your actual wife for some reason. For some reason, Kendrick, you haven't married this girl. You proposed in 2015. It's damn near a decade later. So that's your wife and your girl, but it's not your wife. I mean, you can do what you want, K-Dot, but that is a good question. And then the way he flipped the Michael Jackson, this nigga, ooh-wee, this wigger, cracker, whatever the fuck he is, he rapping. He's rapping. That's all we should give a frick about his fans. Bro, these niggas are rapping, and this brother is rapping on this. I can't. What? Flipping that. Like, it's like what happened to Michael? Like, maybe I'm Prince and you actually Mike. Because that shit is coming from... What? You actually Mike. Mike was praying his speech for change so people believe that he's actually white. Like, Mike was praying his features would change, people would think he was white, because this nigga didn't like himself for whatever, all the reasons he had, as far as being overworked as a child, and having a terrible dad that beat him, and was overworked him, and a mother who didn't stand up against it, and this abuse that him and his family made. He didn't want to be black, or at least he didn't want to appear black. If, like, and we can disagree and believe that, but him to spin that narrative of the whole you a Michael Jackson for real, like, you know, the artiste, like, he's like, nigga, maybe I'm Prince, maybe you Mike Jack, because nigga, you don't even want to live your actual life. Like, something about this girl ain't enough for you, which is crazy because Pusha said the same shit to him, but something about this shit is not enough for you, and it's kind of like, it's a great flip, man. Top, get on pop, breaking some rap for the whites and wait. You say your brother Jermaine, but you only understand like, oh shit. Like, okay, my fault. It's late. But, like, you doing pop records and shit for the whites. Like, you doing everything for these whites' attention and for their fucking acclaim. Which is funny as fuck, because those are the people that are like, Kendrick's killing, he's bodying, it's 4-0. Drake can't even compare to the lyrical miracle ability of Kendrick or Duckworth Lamar. Like, nigga, like, Kendrick's amazing. But, like, can we have the battle and stop dickying, please? But that audience is what has led to that and how they view it. So it's a great flip. Shit, just follow me, right? Because nothing you're saying about me, right? I get on the plane and nothing has changed. I handed a lot of all of my eyes. Basically saying this shit over. I feel like Drake thought that this shit was the fucking one. And it is. The thing about this shit, especially with the ring, you hired a fucking crisis management team? That because you beat up your queen? That's a nuke! Anybody that says he didn't fucking press the red button is a fucking Kendrick dick eater. He pressed it. He just going against another nigga with another red button. You should look at yourself in the mirror before you ever prosecute the nigga across from you, because you don't know what the fuck he know about what you got going on. And that's what the fuck Drake going through. But we can't say that he did not press a red button. Like saying you had a whole crisis management team. Saying that fucking baby, the lighter one, he may not be yours. And if he is yours, you don't even fucking claim it because he ain't black, right? Because you fucking care about blackness so much, but you got a mixed girl. This whole thing about you being pro-black and pro-culture, you've went away from it so many times in your freaking life, Kendrick. And I'm telling you this. It's a crazy diss. It's not as direct and as, like, slow and therapized as Kendrick's, or thought out, I guess you could say, to give Kendrick that benefit. But it's just as scathing. Like, literally just as scathing. So, Family Matters was a fucking, like, a knockdown to me. Like, it's like, boom, but it's not a knockout. And we found that out 30 minutes later when this nigga Kendrick dropped this. Pause. I gotta give y'all some backstory. My fault. I gotta give y'all some backstory on this shit. This nigga posted the Maybach glove for the freestyle, which was good. And then on the cover for this one, it's a shirt that looked like something Drake would wear, especially with the Gonzaga, like, bulldog, especially his dog era. It's the glove for the Maybach shit, like a room tool, some shit that Drake has rapped about, some pills that look like they for your stomach. Some Ozempic shit, some like fake jewelry receipt for some reason. It's like basically saying that he got some fake jewelry, which we know he got money, so him having fake jewelry I don't think really matters. But okay, still a part of it. You wearing fake shit, you a fake nigga, I get it. Like he said, meet the Grams after Family Matters. So you know family's coming. Family, we just talk about family. We got personal. Bet. Now I'm gonna talk directly to your family. Kendrick liked that, man. Can't lie. Let's get into it.
Sorry that that man is your father, let me be honest. It takes a man to be a man, your dad is not responsible. I look at him and wish your grandpa would have wore a condom. I'm sorry that you gotta grow up and you stand behind them. Life is hard, I know. The challenges always go feed us home. Sometimes our parents make mistakes that affect us until we grow. And you're a good kid that need good leadership. Let me be your mentor, since your daddy don't teach you shit. Never let a man kiss on your neck, son. Either you die right there or pop that man in the head, son.
Never. I agree. The rumor that started a while back with the Meek shit that and T.I. kind of confirmed, but like, you never know. Unless you were there, that shit. But letting a man piss on you, Drizzy, is fucking ridiculous. Like, that is some crazy, like, not even self, like, even if you get your ass kicked by these niggas, what type of self-confidence as a man do you not have if you can't stand up for yourself while a nigga pees? Or nigga, fuck, stand up for yourself, run away! I'm running away from piss. I ain't about to fight a nigga that's peeing, but I ain't about to sit there either. So they're like, get the fuck away. Like, in a movie theater at that. It's dark, nigga. Nigga probably can't even see you. Catch your fucking face, man. Like, yeah, he wildin'. But that's old news, kind of, so he just kind of revert. The thing about this one, this was not as calculated as the other two. The first, this was super calculated, had all the right flows. You can tell he worked on that shit. Like, he worked on it like it was an album cut. The next one was more freestyle-y, but it had a good sample that kind of carried and was giving good, like, I got intel, nigga. I got intel. It was a good starter one, but just dropped second. This one was very, I feel like Kendrick wrote that fast. I feel like it didn't have as many like hidden words within it, but it hit home because it came with an angle that didn't need that much double entendres or double meaning. It just, I'm hitting you immediately and straight up.
Never fall in the escort business, that's bad religion. Please remember, you could be a bitch even if you got bitches. Never code switch.
Good point. Just because you got hoes don't mean you ain't no bitch. He told bro to do some push-ups. I need to do some push-ups. Wesley said, nigga, stop taking this fucking medication. I think Kendrick at one point really did respect Drake. So that this battle kind of makes him mad. Like, I respected this nigga. Like, something's wrong with this guy. I kind of feel bad that he's going through this shit. It's kind of the energy he's giving off. To talking to Adonis, like, starting to shit off, but your dad is terrible, nigga. And like, listen to me, I want to be your mentor, is funny as hell.
Your hands, that's law. Don't be ashamed about who you with. That's how you treat your moms. Don't have a kid to hide a kid to hide a kid. You sure. 5% will comprehend, but 95% is lost. Be proud of who you are. Your strength comes from within. Not a superstar, that's real. But you gotta be one of them. And you nothing like him. You'll carry yourself as king. Can't understand me right now. Just pay this when you 18. Dear Sandra, your son got some habits. I hope you don't.
Pause. So I think Dear Adonis is good. It's crazy talking to a nigga's child. That's a crazy flex bomb with all that shit. But a lot of shit wasn't really said. He kind of just said, like, this kind of, your dad's a bad guy. He's a superstar, but he's a bad guy. He be, like, he kind of focused on some kind of surface level shit. Like, he taking those Ozempic. Like, a lot of niggas taking those Ozempic. A lot of women, men, all that taking those Ozempic. Not saying it's a good thing, but not really a diss. But, you know, do some work out, nigga. Work out, little nigga. He trying to make a dime to go D1. But yeah, this next one is disrespectful.
Don't undermine them, especially with all the girls that hurt inside the climate. You're a woman, so you know how it feels to be in alignment with emotions, hoping a man can see you and not be blinded. Dear Dennis, you gave birth to a master manipulator.
It's the second time calling him a manipulator.
I think you should ask for more paper and more paper. And more
questioning paper. If this is that, even though that nigga look just like him, but I get it. Get the point.
Path intuition. The man that liked to play victim. You raised a horrible fucking person. The nerve of you, Dennis. Sandra, sit down. What I'm about to say is heavy. Now listen. Your son's a sick man with sick thoughts. I think looks like him should die. In the wild state, she get fucked up in a cell for the rest of their life. He hits black women, hypersexualizing with kinks of a nympho fetish. Grew facial hair because he understood being a beard just fits him better. He got sex offenders on hold.
Being a beard just fit him better. He basically said he's a sicko. He called this nigga Harvey Weinstein. He said he a beard. So now he's saying this nigga a sicko and he gay. I don't know if he constitutes as a beard. because that would mean he's the like cover up for some straight woman. But it, he might have a beard, like a girl that is, I don't know. But the point is, he's saying he's gay. Like he going in.
He keep on the monthly allowance. That child should never be compromised, and he keeping his child around him. You know, we gotta raise our daughters knowing this.
Man, that's crazy. Like a child shouldn't be compromised. You got niggas around you as pedophiles. That's fucking wild.
Like him lurking. Fuck a rap battle. He should die so all of these women can live with a purpose. I've been in this industry 12 years. I'ma tell y'all one little secret. It's a weird shit going on, and some of these artists be here to police it. They be streaming on the victims all inside of their home. They call them Tinder. Then make videos, sell themselves to further push their agendas. To any woman that be playing this music, know that you're playing your sister. Or better yourself.
That's crazy. Like, I heard the Tinder bar and how that's related to this nigga Drake having a secret Tinder that he sends to women. And he's saying he's a trafficker. Like, he gets women and he manipulates them with his power. That's a crazy accusation. Drake would probably flip it and be like, no, I just be like having a good time and I chill. But nigga, honestly, saying that in the midst of getting accused doesn't sound good. I don't know. Like, this is not a better song than the Drake one. To me, I don't think it's really close musically. This isn't the best Kendrick drop musically, but the shit he's saying is just like, if true, is sick. Like, if what Drake said about Kendrick is true, it's also sick. But the way he's delivering this, I don't know, it makes you believe him for sure.
Selling your niece to the world, those not the good ones. Cat Williams that gave you the truth, so I'ma get mine. The embassy about to get ready too. It's only a matter of time. Hey, LeBron, keep the family away. Curry, we keep the family away. To anybody that embody the love for the kids, keep the family away. They looking at you too if you standing by him. Keep the family away. I'm looking to shoot through any pervert that lives. Keep the family safe.
You called him a pervert. He said the embassy getting raided through. Niggas, if you don't know, you see how the disses are two different vibes. The Drake diss was like, yeah, let's go. Like, this is funny. This is cool. This shit is crazy. Like, telling a nigga, like, the embassy finna get raided. Like, he really saying this nigga Diddy. Like, oh, no. That's a sick proposition. If this nigga has a daughter, okay, I'm getting real serious. Like, I'm getting so serious. If Drake, I'm gonna take the hat off, cause I gotta get straight to it. If this nigga Drake has a daughter, this beef shit over. Kendrick won. If he has a daughter and is partaking in these instances of like potentially human trafficking, which will get you raided eventually, this is sick. Like, I'm not like, as you like listen to it, it's just hard to listen to, damn near, honestly. It's sick. And it's like, these are crazy accusations. They're crazy. Crazy accusations.
Cause our children is the future, but he lives inside confusion. Money's always been illusion, but that's the life he's used to. His father probably didn't claim him either. History do repeats itself. Sometimes it don't need a reason. But I would like to say it's not your fault that he's hiding another child. Give him grace. It's the reason I made Mr. Morale. So our babies like you can cope later. Give you some confidence to go through something. It's hope later. I never want to hear you chase a man because it's fell behavior. Sitting in the club with sugar daddies for validation. You need to know that love is eternity and trumps all pain. I tell you who your father is. Just play this song when it rains. Yes, he's a hit.
This is crazy. Like, this could end up being the sickest song of all time. If we get a situation where it's like Drake is Diddy or worse or anything of that ilk, where it's like this nigga is a sick individual that is trafficking on underage women or even women in general, is manipulating people like seriously, has a kid he's not taking care of, that shit hits home. Being from a single parent household, being a father that don't take care of his kids, especially after you take care of one publicly. So it's like, fuck it, I gotta take care of this one. It makes the Pusha shit even more crazy. I take one or one, but I'm not taking care of that one. Like, that's fucking insane. If this is true, if anything in this is true, it's crazy. And Drake, Kendrick wins. Same thing for Drake, though. Because if anything in that Drake this is true, like the real shit, then that's crazy. And then Drake wins. Unless they both true. And then we're entertaining two of the biggest weirdos in the world. So hopefully none of this shit true. But if this shit true about his daughter, all that shit, it ain't much coming back from that. Like, Drake will still have great music, and you can still listen to it. But Drake, the performer, and the act, and the touring act, and all that shit, get the fuck out of here. Because that's crazy. It's crazy. And Kendrick is so smart, I'm going to step on your fucking release. And I'm stepping on your release with a hit. Because this shit not going to be a hit. It's going to be a hit. Like, it ain't just going to chart because the beef is so hot. Both of these songs might be 1 and 2. If not 1 and 2, they're going to be both top 10. I'm hitting you with this heartfelt shit that even your fans will think is disgusting if true. Because there are some people that can like be like, even if he did hit her, well, that's a bad, but that's not as bad as this. Even though you shouldn't really be like saying what's bad or okay in comparison to assault or bad doings. But that's the truth. That's how niggas feel. Like Chris Brown, he had a mistake. Is different than a nigga like Diddy, where you just fucked up individual. You know, it's two different things. But yeah, let's just try to get through this shit. This is harder to get through because it's less.
Fucking deadbeat that should never say more life meet the ground.
It's less punchlines or catchy moments like Euphoria gave you.
I know you probably thinking I wanted to crash your party. But truthfully, I don't.
It's more like just like character assassination. And that hits hard, especially in beef.
I've a hating bone in my body. It's supposed to be a good exhibition within the game. But you fucked up the moment you called out my family's name. Why you had to stoop so low to discredit some decent people? Guess integrity is lost when the metaphors doesn't reach you. And I like to understand, cause your house was never for a home. 37, but you showing up as a 7-year-old. You got gambling problems, drinking problems, pill popping and spending problems. Bad with money, whorehouse, soliciting women problems. Therapy's a lovely
whorehouse, soliciting women problems. Like, basically paying for pussy problems, which some people may not think is a problem, but accusations.
Strip the ego from the bottom. I try to empathize with you because I know that you ain't been through nothing. Crave entitlement, but want to be like so bad that it's puzzling. No dominance. Let's recap moments when you didn't fit in. No secret handshakes with your friend. No culture cachet to binge. Just disrespecting your mother. Identity's on the fence. Don't know which family would love you. The skin that you living in is compromised and personas. Can channel your mask of men even when standing next to a woman. You a body shamer. You go hide them baby mamas, ain't you? You embarrassed of them. That's not right. That ain't how mama raised us. Take that mask off. I want to see what's under them. Achievements. Why believe you? You never gave us nothing to believe in because you lied about religion.
No, not even, like when you listen to this shit and you go deep into what he's saying, this last verse, he leaves Earth. Like, it's funny because both of their last verses are so strong, which is why I think we need, unless we get concrete evidence that these niggas are weirdos and should no longer be rated in society, which may happen any day the way this shit coming out. I want more records. I want Kendrick to reveal everything he knows. I want Drake to reveal everything he knows Or I wasn't gonna keep lying on each other until we get tired of this shit. Right now, I'm not tired of this shit. This fucking song is damn near lulling me to sleep because also because I'm stayed up a long time. But like Jesus Christ, nigga, like Jesus Christ, he gave us nothing to believe in. Like he's hitting everything. Shit hard to fathom, fam.
You lied about your surgery. You lied about your accent. Hit your past tense, all is perjury. You lied about your ghostwriters. You lied about your crew members. They all pussy. You lied on them. I know they all got you in them. You lied about your son. You lied about your daughter, huh? You lied about them other kids that's out there hoping that you come. You lied about the only artist that can offer you some help. Fuck a rap battle. This a long life battle with yourself.
Fuck a rap battle. This is a long life battle with yourself. Hey, remember, both of these niggas are just putting out accusations. But this shit has gone left. This is barely a rap beef anymore, but if we get more records, we will be here. Shit, rap is war. This is the solo episode. Remember, I don't even got a tag, bro. Remember, we love hip hop, and hip hop loves us sometimes. And it's one of those times where it definitely loves us. This beef has given us great moments, crazy moments. It probably gonna give us 3 to 10 more moments. My Boston accent shit. But in this shit, it's crazy. I went solo for an hour, so shit, we might get on the fucking cast with the boys and go 3 hours or some fucking Twitch shit or something. Like, this shit crazy. But yeah, Rap is War, COE Media. Let me see my way out. 6666. What's Kendrick's? I'm the one. She think I'm the one.